Your time in the wilderness brings strengthening. Mark chapter 1, verses 11 to 13. Then a voice came from heaven, "You are my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." Immediately the Spirit drove him into the wilderness. And he was there in the wilderness 40 days, tempted by Satan, and was with the wild beasts, and the angels ministered to him. As we continue to consider the wilderness in the life of Jesus, we have talked about the fact that the wilderness was a place of separation. It was a place of solitude. It was a place of silence. It was a place of secret, being in secret with the Father. What did all this produce for Jesus? What was the outcome of the Lord Jesus yielding himself to the Holy Spirit to be in the wilderness for that period of time, which was 40 days? We see that in that wilderness time, he was also tempted by the devil. So Satan came and presented his temptations, and we have three of those temptations recorded for us in the fourth chapter of Matthew and Luke, where we find Satan tempting Jesus. And Jesus overcame each one of those temptations. What was the result of Jesus overcoming those temptations? He came out as an overcomer, as a man of strength. Now, this does not mean that when he came out of the wilderness, he never faced another temptation. The Bible records in Luke 4 and verse 13, it says, "Now when the devil had ended every temptation," meaning he was presented with more than those three temptations recorded for us in the Gospels, it says, "He departed from him until an opportune time." That means for a brief moment, Satan went away, but it implies that there were other times later on that Satan would come back with repeated temptations and presenting Jesus Christ, the Son of God, with various temptations. But the point is this, that in the wilderness, he overcame every temptation that was presented to him. He was so strengthened with each one of those victories that he had demonstrated in the wilderness that subsequently, as he journeyed through those 3 years of ministry, or 3.5 years of ministry, whenever the enemy would come, Jesus was strong to overcome each one of those temptations. That's why the writer of Hebrews says that he was tempted in all points, like as we are, and yet without sin. So in that wilderness space where he wasn't separated unto God, he was in solitude, he was in silence, he was in secret, it was also a place where he was so strengthened in overcoming the enemy that as he journeyed through ministry to the day-to-day things of ministry, he was able to overcome anything and everything that Satan brought against him. So understand the importance of your wilderness space, that in that time you are so strengthened that you can walk in victory day after day because you've been strengthened in your wilderness space. Let's pray. Father, we ask you that you will help us understand the importance of just being alone with you in that wilderness space, in that time with you, where we are so strengthened that when we go out into public, when we go out in the ministry, and we go out doing whatever we have to do in life, we've received strength to overcome any and every temptation and scheme of the enemy because we've taken time to be with you alone. Help us to understand the importance of that and help us to do it, we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.